Mr. Fuji, if I may please. Crush, it's confirmed. We understand now that you are one of the 30 participants in the upcoming Royal Rumble. However, it has been further confirmed that another one of the participants is none other than the Macho Man, Randy Savage. What are your plans going to be now?
First of all, Howard, before I discuss my plans for the Macho Man, let me say one thing. Macho Man has been coming out and running his mouth about how his former friend, Crush, has been stabbing him in the back. Macho Man, you got a lot of nerve calling yourself Macho Man. You should call yourself the Macho Crybaby, because that's exactly what you're behaving like. Me stab you in the back? Let me tell you something, and you people shut up and listen. Macho Man, let me tell you something. Master Fuji has been pulling knives out of my back since day one. Thanks to Master Fuji making me see the light about what kind of friend you were, brother. You were trying to take me and turn me into a stepping stone, but you couldn't take it. You couldn't handle it. No, so I'm gonna take you and turn you into my stepping stone. And at Royal Rumble, there's gonna be 30 participants. That's right, and I hope and I pray you survive until I get out there, because I'm going right through everybody like a locomotive to get my hands on you. And I will tear you apart piece by piece, Macho Man. And the Royal Rumble is gonna become your worst nightmare, you understand?
Well, Gorilla, that's a very good point. Very good point. Shock, able to even the score for his tag team partner, Pierre. He's a veteran. Obviously, one half of the WWF Tag Team Champions. Shock.
Music that is.
Well, Jacques, ready for him to cut the music. What's going on here?
Now, I just want to settle something once and for all. Now, you know, Lex Luger, we all know it's a known fact that you have a steel plate in your arm.
We all know that.
And we also know that you knocked out my partner, Pierre, and kept him from...
Fans like that piece of news.
Well, I'm glad you're enjoying this, because I got some news for you. You also kept my partner Pierre from going to Survivor Series.
How long is it going to take to get to the news?
Well, once again, I'm glad you enjoyed that too. Because I got some news for you and Lex Luger. We have made a formal plaint to Jack Tunney. And we have talked. And if all the wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation want to do what I'm fixing to do, we're gonna settle Lex Luger's problem once and for all. And you know what that is?
He may eventually make his point.
I'm very sorry, ladies and gentlemen, but I am not wrestling Lex Luger tonight until I see a doctor's paper that showed that that steel plate was put out of his arm.
Why, you ingrate.
What's he gonna do, boycott, go on strike?
You moron!
I thought we were going to have a match here. Now, what's going on? Lex Luger's steel plate in his right arm. They're surgically implanted.
Everybody does that.
Well, I'm a little confused.
What a gutless wonder.
Well, we think we're going to have a match here, ladies and gentlemen. The officials are here with Jacques and Polo. We'll be right back with whatever happens. Well, we are back here, ladies and gentlemen. quickly, catching Luger coming through the ropes with those vicious kicks right to the kidney area.
Before the bell even rang.
Luger in magnificent condition, looking phenomenal as this capacity crowd begins its chant of USA, USA.
Nice look over the shoulder of manager Johnny Polo. Lex obviously had a game plan coming in here, but Jacques has disrupted it completely.
Jacques with a right hand to the ribs. Irish whip, that's going to be reversed. Jacques into the corner. Oh. Catches Luger coming in with a foot right to the face. And caught Luger with a clothesline. And down goes Lex.
Looks like he was measuring him for that elbow.
Lex Luger, who has had a tremendous rivalry of late with the awesome Ludwig Borga. Certainly was the leader at the WWF Survivor Series when the All-Americans defeated the Ford Fanatics. And Luger back up to a vertical base with short, stinging right hands. Comes with a clothesline. No, he doesn't. Jacques dropped out of sight, and Luger went right over the top rope.
And now it's Luger who's out of sight.
Lex Luger going over the top rope all the way to the floor here. And shot.
Give me a break.
Johnny Polo with those cheap shots. He's kicking Luger right in the head. Polo stomping away at the head of Luger.
That little worm.
What a devious cheap shot. A succession of them by Johnny Polo. And now Jacques trying to widen the advantage.
Well, Jacques is dangerous, especially when he gets you in a compromised position.
He's going for it. Going for the cover.
That was close.
He got a near fall there. And now Jacques sitting back with that camel clutch, testing the magnificent upper body, especially the neck strength of Lex Luger.
Too much upper body strength. Come on, ref. Get that guy off the apron. Look at that.
Jacques with a handful of hair. While the referee was detained with Polo.
That's your pal, Jim Ross.
Well, we talk to him frequently on radio WWF in the USA.
At least he says he is.
He is not my pal, I'll tell you that right now.
Referee looking perhaps to see if Lex wants to pack it in here. Highly unlikely you would get a submission out of this gentleman.
This is a great matchup. Luger in a great deal of trouble. This magnificent athlete, Lex Luger, being tested here. And he is getting some help emotionally. This USA, USA chant helping Luger, and Jacques sensing that.
Moments ago, a little bit of a panic look on the face of Jacques as he saw that he was not going to be successful with that camel clutch.
Luger now firing back up on Jacques. Grabs him by the hand. Takes him face first into the top turnbuckle. Make it three times. And more. As Luger now manhandling Jacques.
He's getting knocked silly here.
He certainly is. Luger really asserting himself physically. The 6'5", 270-pounder is showing his physical dominance on Jacques. Nice backbreaker. Luger measures Jacques and drives the elbow.
Not an ounce of fat. This tremendous athlete.
And now Luger stepping up for the second rope. Here come those right hands.
Oh, inverted atomic drop.
Well, that'll stop you in a hurry. A veteran move by one half of the WWF Tag Team Champions.
Another reversal here and reversed once again. Oh, no. Down, maybe out.
Jacques ran right into Luger, and now Luger, there's a referee, he's out of it, and Polo tripped Luger. Luger was setting Jacques up for that forearm smash.
Get him!
Polo trips Luger, and now Jacques can regain the advantage, perhaps.
Lex took one heck of a header there down into the canvas.
Both men colliding.
Head to head.
I tell you, we know that Jacques and Pierre, the Quebecers, have been avoiding the Steiner brothers like the plague. But I'm sure that Jacques' mind
is far, far from tag team action now. The referee, Lex Luger, and Jacques are all down, and look who's coming.
Oh, wait a minute.
It's Pierre. Pierre coming to the ring here.
Saying something. Unfortunately, it's in French. We can't pick it up.
And
shock here and make the referee find us.
Oh, that's a
come on.
Highway robbery. And he kicked out. Luger kicked out. And Pierre can't believe it. Luger kicked out. And Pierre, those clubbing blows from the 300 pounder. Luger keeps getting up. Look at the fight. And look at the courage. And Lex Luger.
And the referee still doesn't realize that it's Pierre and not Jacques inside.
Luger, Irish whips in the ropes. He missed a clothesline.
This week will be at the WWF Royal Rumble to defend his Intercontinental Championship. Let's welcome the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
Oh yeah, what an opportunity. Here he comes. Ray Rougeau about ready to interview the bad guy. He is oozing with machismo, conspicuous by his absence. The gold that at one time was around this neck. However, he unquestionably, Dan still has the gold around the waist.
Yeah, but the question is, will he keep that gold? Will IRS take it, or will Shawn Michaels finally settle this dispute once and for all?
Well, when we go to the Royal Rumble, it's going to be Irwin who has his shot.
Just a toothpick there.
Is Razor styling or what?
All right, Razor Ramon.
Yo, Ray. What's wrong with this picture?
Obviously, the only thing I could see is your gold chains are missing from around your neck.
I say it many, many times. If something happens to this, then something happens to you.
Well, you know, Razor, we all witnessed during your altercation with Shawn Michaels, somehow your gold conveniently disappeared. Now, allegedly, IRS, Erwin R. Scheister, is the man who stole your gold, and he carries it in his briefcase now.
Your tax man. Oye, me chico. You steal from Razor Ramon. You rip off the bad guy. Do you know how long and hard I work to buy this precious gold? How dear to mi corazón, man, my heart, this gold is? Do you know, tax man, what a guy like me can do to a guy like you?
All right, Razor Ramon, you've made it quite clear that at the WWF Royal Rumble, you intend on regaining the gold around your neck and retaining your Intercontinental title, which leads me to another question. The fans are concerned about your physical condition. Now everyone witnessed Shawn Michaels apply your move, the Razor's Edge, a maneuver which many consider the most devastating move in the WWF to you, not once, but twice, out of the ring, on the concrete floor. Now, how much has that taken out of you?
You're red. Nobody knows better than the bad guy how deadly the Razor's Edge is. That's why I use it. And Taxman, where I come from, Chico, it's not how many times you get knocked down. Oh no. It's how many times you get up. So everybody, look at me now. I'm up and I'm coming to the Royal Rumble. And Taxman, I'm bringing the gold that cannot be bought. You want it? You gotta fight, Chico. And one on one, nobody beats the bad guy.
Goodness, what a great matchup that's going to be. Razor Ramon squaring off against Erwin R. Scheister.
Sparky's on his way to the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, yes, Yokozuna, 1994. It's a brand new year. It's a time to reflect amongst past mistakes, fine print and contracts, inept management, but also a time to look towards the future. The future! Oh, yes! What is your future, Yokozuna? Well, you might say that 1994 is the year of the casket! Oh, yes!
I've made my New Year's resolution, Yokozuna. May you rest in peace.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week are the World Wrestling Federation champion, Yokozuna, his manager, Mr. Fuji, and his American spokesperson, Jim Cornette.
Well, here comes James E. Cornette in a rather large pair of light blue double knits.
Boy, he didn't look happy either.
He is not happy. Well, he got duped.
Certainly did.
Cornette got outsmarted, and I've known him for a long time. That does not happen very often.
Well, the formaldehyde king did him in.
Yokozuna, as awesome as ever, got to be close to 600 pounds. His official weight, they tell me, is 568 pounds.
Please.
Look at the girth of the champion. He doesn't have a very happy look on his face here as we begin 1994.
He's a marked man, Jim Ross.
Folks young and old alike can't believe the size of this athlete. Casket match rules for the WWF title at the WWF Royal Rumble.
I want to say one thing, something I'm not very happy about. Something that Yokozuna and Mr. Fuji are not very happy about. Is this conspiracy in the World Wrestling Federation? There's been a lot of people making allegations around here lately. There's some home cooking going on, some pork barrel politics. I signed a contract for Royal Rumble for Yokozuna to meet The Undertaker in a title match. But the contract that I get back in the mail has some fine print stuck in it by Paul Bearer saying it's going to be some kind of match where you've got to win, you've got to stuff your opponent in some kind of big box. Now let me explain something. I watched that contract carefully and there was no fine print in the one that I signed. It was added afterwards. There's people trying to create trouble between me and the master, Mr. Fuji. And there's also people making a lot of allegations that there was fear in the eyes of Yokozuna when he faced The Undertaker at Survivor Series. There wasn't any fear in those eyes. He is not scared of The Undertaker. I swear he's not. I know he's not. I asked him, and he is not scared. He's not scared.
But Jim, The Undertaker did what no man has ever done before. He not only withstood the bonsai drop, he got up from it.
That's exactly right. That's what happened.
I don't know how he... The reason for that was because I don't know how he did it, but I'll guarantee you this, we're going to find out before the Royal Rumble, and you may have got up from one Undertaker, but how about two or three or four or ten, as many as it takes. That's what Yokozuna is going to deliver to you at the Royal Rumble, Undertaker, but you do have your chance at the World Wrestling Federation title, and that's exactly what it is. It's a chance, one chance. Because as you will remember, I inserted a clause in the contract at SummerSlam that Lex Luger only got one opportunity, and that's what he did get, and he didn't capitalize on it, and he's never gotten another one. Well, the same thing goes, Undertaker. You've got a chance. You can get in that ring, and you can defeat Yokozuna and be the World Wrestling Federation champion and wear the gold and all the glory and all the prestige that goes along with it. But if you don't make it good, if you don't please all of these stupid, moronical, imbecile fans of yours that think you're so great, then you'll never get another chance because there's no rematch, Undertaker. The only thing that disturbs me, Stan, is that that's the stipulation that Paul Bearer has put in this thing when he put one over on us, is that the loser, to win the match, you have got to take your opponent and you've got to stuff him in a big box at ringside.
Cornette, that's no box. That's a casket.
Don't say that word.
What word? Casket?
Don't say Stan. Wait, Yoko, it's okay. It's okay, Yoko. Call me
now. I think about a sore
spot
here.
Do not say that word.
Look at the look.
Jim, that's a custom-made double-wide casket.
Double deep.
Wait. Oh, he doesn't like that. Yokozuna doesn't like, he dropped the belt.
Don't say the word casket. Don't say that word. Now listen, he's not scared. It's just that there's some people that have little phobias. They have phobias about heights, They have phobias about spiders. They have phobias about flying. He has a little phobia about those things that have lids on them that are boxes that you put people in when they go away. You know what I mean? Those things. He gives him the creeps. He's not scared. It just gives him the creeps. And who would want to touch one of those things anyway? They're moldy and ugly. They got a lid on them. When you close the lid, there's no air. There's no light. So he don't want to touch it. He does not want to touch it. But he will put the Undertaker in one. And I guarantee you this Undertaker, I don't care how many lives you've gotten. I know you've already gone through a bunch of them. But if you don't make good on the Royal Rumble and win that belt, you will never, as long as you live or as long as you walk the earth after you die, have another chance at this belt. And he is not scared. He just gets the creeps when you say the word casket.
Looks scared to me, Jim.
I think that that man, The Undertaker, will indeed be the next WWF champion. You can say phobia. You can say that he's just a little annoyed. I think Yokozuna is afraid of the consequences that await him in this casket match for the WWF title at this year's WWF Royal Rumble.
Old Glory waves as never before, ladies and gentlemen, on the massive chest of an American original, Lex Luger. Lex, really on a tear as of late here in the WWF, a great deal of positive momentum headed your way. A victory last week on Monday Night Raw. This past weekend, we saw you victorious over yet another Quebecer. However, does that momentum hit a wall if, in fact, you're not allowed entry into the Royal Rumble? Jack Tunney will make his decision this coming weekend as to whether or not you're going to be in or out. Unquestionably, America has spoken. They want you to be one of the 30 participants.
Well, the moment of truth has arrived, and you're right, I am on pins and needles, very anxious to hear a decision. But no matter what the decision, I want to thank each and every person out there who voted for me, who supported me and wants to see me in the Royal Rumble. I'd like to be in it. I want to compete, and that's all I ask for, is the chance.
The winner of the Royal Rumble will face the WWF champion, whomever that may be, at WrestleMania. So, based upon that, do you feel that this whole protest to begin with was a little bit arrogant on Yokozuna's part?
Absolutely. I'm glad you said whomever, because we talked about the competition in the Royal Rumble. What about the competition that Yokozuna has to face here in the World Wrestling Federation until WrestleMania? So I think it's a very arrogant assumption for Yokozuna, Cornette, and his people to assume he'll still be the champion at that point. I don't understand the logic.
Well, I think the logic is clearly, at any odds, they don't want to face you.
Preventive medicine, yeah.
Yes, but from there, let's assume that Jack Tunney says, no, Lex, I agree with Yokozuna, and therefore you're not going to be allowed entry into the Royal Rumble. How do you handle that?
Well, at this point, that doesn't even enter my mind, because I always try to think positive, always try to be upbeat, and if that decision does come down, then I'll deal with it. But until then, I can only control my own destiny and continue to win and be optimistic and know that maybe I'll get the chance.
We've hit upon the negative. What if you're not allowed into the Royal Rumble? Let's talk about the positive. What if you are allowed?
Well, they're going to see one fired up Lex Luger. I mean, what a great opportunity to compete in a showcase event like the Royal Rumble. And I know if I am allowed to compete, it's once again because of support, I think, that was shown for me by you fans out there that influenced Jack Tunney. And if I step in that ring, I step in for one reason and one reason only, and that's to win, and I won't let you down.
Well, Lex, let's hope you're allowed entry. If you are, best of luck to you.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. Lex Luger, ladies and gentlemen, an American original.
I guess you're pretty pleased with yourself, aren't you, Johnny? Huh?
Of course, wouldn't you be? I defeated Marty Jannetty. One, two, three.
Amazing man, huh? Amazing man, although with a little help of your Quebecers.
Oh,
wait,
stop
a minute.
It.
Wait a minute. Here comes Marty Jannetty now.
What's he doing out here with the man?
Too happy at all.
What's he got to get out here for? Hey.
Marty Jannetty and the 1-2-3 kid. If you have something to say, gentlemen, there's the microphone.
Let me just get one thing straight right now, Johnny Polo. Don't come out here running your mouth telling anybody how you beat me last week, because you didn't beat me. You and that Quebecer beat me when a third was standing over here. So let me tell you something right now before I smack it up your face. What I want you to do is put your money where your mouth is, boy. You're talking about beating me and the 1-2-3 kid. Here's the 1-2-3 kid. Here I am. Why don't you put a tag match, me against your Quebecers? Can you do that?
You know, I'd like to, but You know, we got the Royal Rumble coming up against the Hart Brothers, and it wouldn't be prudent at this time.
Johnny, the other week you come out here saying how you can beat both of us put together. You don't seem to be so confident now. Why don't you either put up or shut up?
What about it? What about it? How about a match next week, the Quebecers against the Kids in Moncton?
Okay, I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll put it up. Okay, fine.
One more. You put the titles on the line right now. Next
week. Not the titles. Not the titles.
No confidence.
Are you scared?
You call me scared?
Are you scared? Are you not confident of your team?
They're tough enough. All right, we'll do it. But it's only going to be a tune-up match for the Hart Brothers at the Royal Rumble.
I can't believe it.
It's done. Deal. The titles are on the line next week.
All right, thank you very much. I guess the tag title is going to be up for grabs, ladies and gentlemen, next week.
After great deliberation, I have determined that Lex Luger should be granted entry into the WWF Royal Rumble. However, he will be joined by two other entries represented by Mr. Fuji. They are Tenryu and the Great Kabuki. All 30 participants have now been entered into the WWF Royal Rumble, the winner of which will meet the WWF champion, whomever it may be, at WrestleMania 10.
Say we all have been very impressed with the overwhelming support for Lex Luger, ladies and gentlemen, entering the Royal Rumble. And speaking of being impressed, you have to be impressed with the size, agility, the quickness, and the strength of Yokozuna.
Look at the size of the World Wrestling Federation champion. He continues this to bulk up and get bigger and bigger week after week.
No wonder The Undertaker is talking double wide, double deep.
Better go for a triple wide to get all that in.
Then again, it could be the Undertaker stuffed into the coffin of the Royal Rumble. This is a special handicap matchup. Yokozuna locking up with Scott Taylor and Bert Centeno in a handicap matchup, a rarity here on WWF Superstars.
Well, there's no doubt in my mind that Yokozuna will greatly outweigh both of his opponents combined.
No doubt. Mr. Fuji and Jim Cornette, manager and official spokesperson of Yokozuna. They've been very, very busy campaigning on behalf of Yokozuna. Rest in peace. Oh, my! We had occasion to pick up these pre-recorded comments from Mr. Fuji earlier on as it relates to the compromise agreement, if you would, worked out with WWF President Jack Tunney earlier this week. Here now the comments of Mr. Fuji.
So, President Jack Tunney, you gave the permission that Lex Luger may participate in the Royal Rumble. Very good. I, Mr. Fuji, hired two big Japanese wrestlers from Japan, Tenryu and the Great Kabuki, for my own personal insurance that you, Lex Luger, will never survive the Royal Rumble.
Well, Mr. Fuji's clever, huh? He says they are Japanese wrestlers from Japan.
Well, very...
I mean, they can't very well be Japanese wrestlers from Italy or something, can they? Look at this! Yokozuna!
You know, every time I see a handicap match, Vince, I just can't help reflecting back to
drop kick. Wait a minute. Yokozuna's backed up and another.
No, not a chance.
I beg your pardon.
Yeah, I was just saying I can't help but reflect back to one of the great Hall of Famers of all time, Andre the Giant, the master of the handicap match.
Oh, my goodness. Yes, indeed. 7 feet, 4 inches. Over the 500-pound mark, Andre the Giant. Everyone remembers the one and the only Andre.
Can you imagine Andre and Yokozuna facing off in the ring? Unbelievable.
That would be most interesting. Listen to this.
What are you saying there?
Rest in peace. Yes, but I, for one, am looking forward to the encounter. The one-of-a-kind, matchup. The casket match at the Royal Rumble. The Undertaker against Yokozuna. And that has captured the imagination of every WWF fan all over the world.
I'm sure it hasn't slipped Yokozuna's mind, the fact that he bonsai splashed The Undertaker. The Undertaker did not even feel the effects, sat bolt upright and looked at him right dead in the eyes.
You're referring to the Survivor Series.
Exactly.
Yokozuna, indeed, you can see the fear and the respect in his eyes after bonsai splashing Undertaker. Look at this. Yokozuna manhandling Centeno. Uh-oh. Off the rope!
Oh, my gosh. Is there a grease spot there?
There could very well be. But at the Royal Rumble, grease and all will be in the casket. Who will be in there? Will it be Yokozuna. As we said before, Yoko, not pleased with his management, when they overlooked the fine print that Undertaker's manager, Paul Bearer, had placed in the contract, the fact it would be a casket match. Yokozuna does not like being in this tight match at all. Wait a minute. Oh, come on. What is this now? Centeno has scooped and oh! Oh, my goodness!
This might be a double beef whopper coming up here.
On their feet, they know what's going to happen. No! Look at this! Yokozuna now in! Unbelievable! Yokozuna, one of the most awesome World Wrestling Federation champions, perhaps of all time. Yokozuna, with his martial arts skills, his sumo skills, can he be defeated by anyone in the WWF today? Is off with The Undertaker in a matchup. I might remind everyone that The Undertaker's never lost. Wait a minute. What's this? The lights are out.
Oh, Mr. Bowman. Oh, Mr. Bowman. I read your fine print in the contract. You know the
Yokozuna, it will only take me one time. You and that rotting flesh you call an entourage, you've made a big mistake. Yokozuna, I don't make mistakes. Bury them.
Unbelievable! A visit to the Undertaker's workshop in Yokozuna.
Look at his face, Vince.
He can't believe his eyes.
He's petrified. Look at him.
Gentlemen, my guests this week are accompanied by their manager, Johnny Polo. They are the reigning WWF Tag Team Champion, Jacques and Pierre, the Quebecers.
And yes, the Quebecers, as we stated before, headed this Monday night to Monday Night Raw, defending the Tag Team Championship on the one-year anniversary show against Marty Jannetty and the 1-2-3 Kid.
I understand there's going to be a big party, and I love parties. You gonna be there?
Oh, yeah.
It seems that you have had your problems as of late with one Lex Luger.
I hate Lex Luger. He's a yellow-bellied coward. First of all, he sticks a piece of metal on his elbow so he can be like the Bionic Man or something. Then he has a match with Pierre. Knocks him out. Then he has a match with Jacques. Knocks him out. All alone in the ring with 10 of our friends, and you'll find out you're not such a knockout after all.
All right, gentlemen, in 2 weeks, these coveted WWF Tag Team belts will be on the line against the brother team of Owen and Bret Hart.
Guess what's in the way, no? Royal Rumble, Owen be Bret Hart, of course I do.
Could you extend us a little courtesy and speak some English?
Hey, we don't care about English. We don't care about Americans. Let me tell you one thing. There is no one in the World Wrestling Federation that is close. to prove what kind of champions we are. This Monday night on Raw, we will be defending the belts against Marty Jannetty and the 1-2-3 Kid, who are much worthier opponents than those stupid Hart brothers.
And I'll tell you what, too. We're going to show the world that we are not closet champions. We are fighting champions. And come after we take care of those two, come Royal Rumble, we're going to show you what brotherly love is all about.
We have heard from the Provokers. They're on their way to the Royal Rumble to face the Hitman and the Rocket. And this Monday night, who knows? We'll be back.
I can't tell you how excited I am to finally be allowed in the Royal Rumble. I'm thankful to Jack Tunney for rendering the proper decision, in my opinion. But most of all, I'm thankful to you, the fans of the World Wrestling Federation, because I know that without you and your continued loyalty and support, that this opportunity to wrestle in the Royal Rumble wouldn't have been possible in the first place. Now, about this great compromise with Mr. Fuji. I can't concern myself with that. I'm a competitor. I'm stepping in there with 29 other of the greatest competitors the World Wrestling Federation has ever seen. It's every man for himself. There's no friends, only foes. Now, the best way I know how to express my appreciation of this opportunity, thanks to you, is by my performance, and that's by winning the Royal Rumble. Thank you very much.
Royal Rumble. Nothing else is better for Ludwig Borga than this event. Every man for themselves. That's how Mr. Borga's been doing all his life. I don't give no mercy, and I don't want more mercy. And you, Tatanka, you don't even have to worry about the Royal Rumble, because when I'm finished with you after our match, you're out.
Borga, talk is cheap. You speak with a forked tongue. The last time we met, you found out the savage that you created. But now, at the Royal Rumble, you will find out what you have really made, the animal that you have really created, and you will find out that you will not make it to the Royal Rumble, because I will destroy you in our match.
Is scheduled for one.
And Dr. Clown, by currently the way, is headed to Middletown, New York, at the Middletown Rhode High Island. School, a special WWF fundraiser benefiting the Middletown Varsity Ryan. Club. On hand, Doink the Clown, along with the Quebecers, Irwin R. Scheister, Hitman himself, Bret Hart, Monday night, January 24th, at the Middletown High School of Middletown, New York. Also on hand, the Steiner brothers, Rick and Scott. What a combination they are. And speaking of combinations, the Beast from the East and Luna Vachon. You might say they sort of deserve each other.
Well, you know, I was talking to Luna just this past week, and she assured me that one of her New Year's resolutions is to break out of that conservative shell.
Well, you know, she does dress a little on the conservative side, doesn't she?
Yeah, I hope she'll loosen up for the big party, Monday Night Raw party.
Well, she's going to be there. I don't know how loose she's going to be, because Bam Bam himself headed to the anniversary, the first year anniversary of Monday Night Raw this Monday night, and Bam Bam meeting Bastion Booger. Booger a little carried away with Luna Vachon, if you can imagine that. Bam Bam backing Brian Walsh to the corner. Bam Bam with Walsh, look at that maneuver!
That's the highest hip toss I've ever seen, unbelievable!
Bam Bam Bigelow is... Wait a minute, Walsh, look at that kick out! Nicely done, Brian Walsh now, coming off the rope, Walsh!
Oh, no!
Bam Bam ramming the head into Walsh! Bam Bam, a human battering ram! Walsh showing signs of brilliance there momentarily, but unfortunately...
Now he's showing signs of unconsciousness.
Yes, I believe so. The power of the Beast from the East is awesome. And Bam Bam against Bastion Booger. Who is the stronger of the two? Who is the larger of the two? Who is likely to be the victor between those two? We're going to find out this Monday night. Bam Bam did like anyone coming anywhere near his main squeeze, Luna Vachon.
Well, in that case, I take back what I said.
It appears as though Bastion Booger became a bit enamored last Monday night with that lady right there. And the only question is whether or not Luna Vachon will leave the ring this Monday night with Bam Bam, or will she dump him and leave the ring with Bastion Booger? We had an occasion to pick up these comments from Bam Bam and Luna referencing the Royal Rumble.
It's Rumble time, that's right, the WWF Royal Rumble, and I'm gonna be in it. No friends, all enemies, it's every man for himself. Winner gets a shot to be the next WWF champion.
Presence of mind to know exactly where he is at all times.
Yeah, big mistake. Don't ever jump on someone's shoulders who's that big and that tall.
And look at this. Bam Bam going up to the top. Bam Bam Bigelow. Oh, forget about it. Unbelievable. And an easy pre-count, I'm sure, yes. Bam Bam Bigelow. What's in that bucket?
Wait a minute, coming up from behind. Look, there's Dink coming up from behind. Bam Bam Bigelow. Dink throws a bucket. Bam Bam goes in balance. Down he goes on a concrete floor.
They just emptied. They emptied a bucket. I think those are marbles. Oh, wait a minute, watch out.
Everyone knows Shawn Michaels still claims to be the undisputed Intercontinental Champion. Well, that is disputed, but one day we're going to clear up this matter once and for all. Joining us now, ladies and gentlemen, will be Shawn Michaels and his bodyguard wrestler extraordinaire, Diesel. Yes, there they are, gentlemen. Thank you very much for joining us this week. And, the question is to you, Shawn Michaels. I would suggest that Razor is counting the days until he steps into the ring with you and defends the Intercontinental Championship. I'm sure Razor is very much looking forward to that.
I don't think at this time Razor Ramon can count at all, let alone counting the seconds till he gets a hold of the undisputed Intercontinental Champion. I mean, if you ask me, he ought to know by now that it's curtains for him.
I see. Well, you seem sort of nonchalant about the opportunity. Don't you want to prove yourself as well, Mr. Michaels?
Shawn Michaels, the heartbreak kid, the wrestler of the 90s, prove himself? You kidding me? I'm proven already.
I see. Well, we have seen Diesel's work from behind the curtain, so to speak. I wonder, in a rematch with Razor Ramon, would we see the presence of Diesel anywhere?
Are you kidding? Well, it depends. Would he pick curtain number one or curtain number two? I got news for you. It doesn't matter what you pick. One, you get Shawn Michaels, and two, you get Diesel. We're a team. Big man.
Would you concur with that, Diesel?
Absolutely. Hey, Razor, how's that jaw? Matter of fact, how's the back of that skull?
Well, there's no doubt you gentlemen like to think of yourselves as a team. However, I'd like to remind you that you both have entered the WWF Royal Rumble matchup itself, two of the 30 participants, and it's every man for himself. Now, if you get my drift, obviously that means that instead of partners, you two gentlemen could oppose each other. What are your feelings on the subject matter?
Look, I know what you're trying to do here, okay? But it's not gonna happen between Diesel and I, all right? We are a team, and we're gonna take everybody in the Royal Rumble and throw them out one by one.
Well, let's give you a hypothetical then, Diesel, if you don't mind. Let's assume that it's down to three people. You, Shawn Michaels, and another competitor. Shawn Michaels and the other competitor in the corner, both of them halfway out over the top rope. What do? Do you throw them both out? Exactly what do you do at that point, just as a hypothetical?
I make the save, yeah. I save my partner, that's what I do. I throw the other guy out, pull Sean in. That's what I do.
Of course, that's right.
All right, then let's continue with that line of thinking, if you don't mind, gentlemen. And then from there, Diesel, it then becomes Shawn Michaels versus Diesel. I mean, only one man can win the Royal Rumble.
Don't worry about that.
Winner of the Royal Rumble could wind up at WrestleMania being the World Wrestling Federation champion. So what do you do? It's two of you left in the ring. Then what?
I've got a plan for all that, okay? I'm the undisputed Intercontinental Champion. I've proven myself. I've stood the test of time. All we do is Diesel steps over the top rope, goes to the floor,
I get the title shot, and then
he comes with me.
I can't imagine that at all. I can't imagine Diesel stepping over the top rope for anyone. I mean, Diesel, wake up, listen to this. Diesel, the WWF champion, huh?
Yeah, I like that. I could live with that. What's wrong with that?
What? There's nothing wrong with that, okay? There's nothing wrong with that at all. Look, you don't understand. I'm the wrestler here. You're the bodyguard. I'm going to bring you along with me. I mean, come on. I drug him.
Yeah, but champ.
Yeah, you'll be the champ's bodyguard, just like you've been before. You're the Intercontinental Champion's
bodyguard. I'd like to be the champ. You got a belt, man. Let me be the champ.
Look, there's nothing wrong with standing ringside. I drug Jannetty around for years and let him...
Hey, I'm no Jannetty.
Look, I'm not implying that you are. I know you're a man yourself. You're the biggest, baddest man in the World Wrestling Federation. I know that, but I'm the wrestler of the 90s. I'm the man whose destiny is to be the World Wrestling Federation champion. Your destiny is to be there by my side.
Oh, well, let me get this straight then. You two gentlemen expect everyone to believe that you're going to trust each other. Is that it? I mean, surely when you signed on for the WWF Royal Rumble matchup itself, you knew it was every man for himself. And when you knew that the possibility of clashing was going to be there, let's face it, your relationship may never be the same again, huh?
Look, we know what the Royal Rumble's all about. We know it's every man for himself. We are man enough and good enough friends to know that if it does come down to Diesel...
Yeah, then all hell's going to break loose, right? Because, Diesel, you clearly do not trust Shawn Michaels. And Shawn Michaels, it's obvious you don't trust Diesel.
That is not true.
That is not true. You're putting words in our mouth.
Exactly.
You're putting words in our mouth.
Well, thank you very much for joining us, Shawn Michaels and Diesel, ladies and gentlemen.
Boy, that's my baby right there. Hello, everybody. My name is Thurman Fox. My friends, they call me Sparky. Listen to the roar of these engines. Smell that fuel burning. I'm just so excited I can't stand it. I'm trapped in the seat of that race car, and I'm running down that straightaway, and I'm wide open, pedal to the metal. Just like when I come to the World Wrestling Federation, I'm going to be wide open, pedal to the metal, and ain't nobody going to stop Sparky Plug.
The list is complete. All the participants are in. Vegas odds say that Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid, is the odds-on favorite. What else is new?
Oh, boy! Just 2 weeks away to Royal Rumble! Boy, that thing's turning darkster! We can't wait! A little buddy, he's gonna be right there by my side to make sure nobody gets me from behind! And if I win, I get a shot at that big, beautiful belt at WrestleMania 10!
Hart Brothers, Royal Rumble is not that far off! And before we get around to beating you up, or actually having you beat each other up since there's a little animosity there, we're gonna take on Marty Jannetty and the 1-2-3 Kid this Monday night as a little tune-up match.
That's right, you could call it a warm-up. 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty. But just to show you that we're not closet champions, we're fighting champions. And then Royal Rumble, we're coming to hearts. After we beat you up, we'll let you guys beat yourself up.
Razor Ramon, you've been going around telling everybody that I stole the fool's gold that you wear around your neck. Well, let me explain something, Ramon. Nobody calls IRS a thief, and for accusing me at Royal Rumble, I'm gonna take all your gold.
Yo, tax man, you rip off Razor Ramon? Estupido. Nothing is lower than a thief. 2 weeks, Chico. You want this gold? Can't steal it. Gotta fight.
County Center in White Plains.
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 300.
Well, it ain't
the hours and the minutes to the forthcoming Royal Rumble, when he'll get still another opportunity. This will be the third time that these two have met. Maybe three will be the lucky number. Ludwig Borga is waiting with bated breath, Jim Ross.
Yeah, and as I said earlier, I really believe that Borga will go into that matchup at the WWF Royal Rumble as the favorite. And that's only my opinion. I'm certainly not taking anything away from Tatanka, but I just think Borga is a double tough individual.
Well, Borga certainly brings a whole lot to the table. And this guy right here, Tatanka, has to use this kind of stuff. Those reverse knife edges, his speed, his agility, his quickness, if he wants to come out on top. Otherwise, it's going to be a long evening.
Glancing blow there by Massinger. He's a 300-plus pounder.
He hasn't missed too many meals.
Oh, he's in his chest is turning bright red. You know, not only will Tatanka and Borga meet one-on-one, they will also both be competing in the Royal Rumble matchup itself.
Well, and depending on whether the Royal Rumble itself takes place before the singles match, nobody really knows that at this point in time, but, you know, either one could be incapacitated.
Tatanka.
Oh, didn't miss with that one.
Certainly seems to be more aggressive. Maybe he went to see Geronimo. I bet he's Wes Studi's favorite wrestler is Tatanka.
Wouldn't surprise me.
Yeah, Wes Studi's in my neck of the woods, really.
I know that.
Yes, sir.
We got a lot of Native Americans out there in Oklahoma.
You better believe it. And one of them going up top there, the Lumbee Indian.
Stranger things than that have happened in the World Wrestling Federation. And take a look at that. Bastion Booger to face Bam Bam Bigelow. Bastion Booger had a huge breakfast here in Richmond at Mon Pa Hatfield Diner. And look out from behind. He may lose that breakfast. Bam Bam Bigelow going to work on Bastion Booger. Bam Bam last week, ladies and gentlemen, was infatuated with Luna Vachon. Luna felt pity for Bam Bam and started to rub his hump. And nonetheless, Booger Rudder was out of ringside, and well, that hump was rubbed. And Luna Vachon, well, she didn't like what happened after that. Neither did Bam Bam Bigelow. So these two big Bohemians are going at it. Booger! Oh.
It's all about jealousy, Vince McMahon.
And a woman's in there somewhere, or at least Luna Vachon. Bam Bam Bigelow against Bastion Booger. And this was not scheduled to be a pretty sight under any stretch of the imagination.
You know, I heard that Bastion Booger chipped Luna Vachon's tooth on that kiss.
Oh, look at that, to the outside, and now, all of a sudden, Bastion Booger has the advantage. Vachon, where will she wind up tonight? Will she wind up with the... Wait a minute, I think she's blowing kisses. Luna Vachon is blowing kisses to Bastion Booger.
What is she
she's
doing?
Actually blowing kisses to him.
Opposites attract, I'm not sure.
Look at this. Lorena Bobbitt's on trial, and maybe Luna might be after this. Look at this. Oh, Bam Bam Bigelow coming up from behind.
Once bit, twice shy.
Bam Bam, oh my, ramming Bastion Booger down to the steps. I mean, these guys are 400 and some odd pounds a piece are huge.
That picture would make one hell of a postcard.
By the way, Friday you can bet on plenty of laughs when Richard Dreyfuss spends a day at the races and Let It Ride. Look at this. Terry Garr co-stars in the USA movie Friday night, 9 o'clock Eastern, 8 Central. Let It Ride, and that's what's happening right now. Bam Bam Bigelow. And Booger.
He did it.
Wow,
he slammed Bastion Booger. Give him credit.
Bam Bam Bigelow. Going up now. Going up to the top. Oh, my goodness. Bastion Booger on the receiving end of that. And a victory for Bam Bam Bigelow.
Bam Bam.
Here is home winner, Bam Bam.
There you see.
Bigelow.
What a daily double that is. Luna Vachon, along with the Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow. And Bastion Booger was smitten earlier with Luna. Wait a minute. Wait, what's going on here? She just slapped it. There can be no doubt now. There can be no doubt in Bastion Booger's mind as to where he stands with Luna Vachon. That's too bad. That's really too bad.
I hope the attorneys don't get mixed up in this.
Oh, you can bet they will. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're told the Quebecers are going to be standing by. However, before we take you to the Quebecers, let's take you to this important speak, and you can bet the Quebecers are... Hello, gentlemen. Quebecers, along with Johnny Polo, you don't look too happy.
Oh, it stinks. I mean, I can't believe we got beat by a bunch of losers like that. I mean, right, they pulled the tights, they had a handful of hair. It's all right, Johnny, it's all right. You know why it's all right, McMahon?
No, I have no idea why it's all
right. I'm gonna tell you why. Because we got a genius as a manager.
Johnny.
You signed a rematch for us, Johnny.
Yeah,
you did.
Yeah.
In case those two little punies would fluke on us. Let me tell you something, Johnny. We're gonna go get those boys in Madison Square Gardens, the contract that you signed for us, and we're going to the Royal Rumble to beat the Hearts with our titles, McMahon.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I signed the contract Monday night next Monday, Madison Square Garden. We're gonna take those titles back, and we're going to the Royal Rumble.
How about that, McMahon?
Welcome back, everyone, to Monday Night Raw. Yes, that's what it's all about. The Macho Man Randy Savage, you will be here next week to square off against Irwin R. Shyster, and Crush will be at ringside as well for commentary.
It's going to be a tune-up for me for the Royal Rumble 12 days away. And I'll tell you what, Crush doing the commentary.
Listen up, Macho Man, and listen good. You better enjoy yourself and have your party tonight, because next week right here on Monday Night Raw, it's not going to be a party when you face Irwin R. Shyster. Because right here... Oh, wait a minute! Wait just a moment!
Oh, my goodness! Oh, look at... Oh, my... Oh! Look at this! Irwin R. Shyster! Macho Man Randy Savage one-on-one! Next week on Monday Night Raw! Happy birthday! Monday Night Raw!
Lex Luger, super lean, ripped to the bone, and the only thing ripped about Bastion Luger might be his tights. Nonetheless, this is not a physique contest. This is a WWF. Just who will be victorious between Lex Luger and Bastion Luger? Welcome, everyone, to WWF Superstars. Vince McMahon here along with Dan. In the Rumble.
Yes, indeed, we're only 1 week away.
What is that? Maybe a little snack. And it could be that the big man Booger could run out of gas if this match goes any length at all. Booger now, locking up with Luger, and you see Booger there exerting his rather substantial power. Booger weighed in at what, last stand?
I believe 401 pounds. Did he tip the scale or crush the scale?
I don't know.
Luger coming off the rope.
Tackle, he goes nowhere. Another shoulder block attempt.
Luger for the third time comes off.
Underneath the clothesline, Lex Luger. Right in the clutch of the bastard Luger. Luger down on the canvas. That may take a rip. Two in and up.
Oh.
I can't imagine what it's like to be power slammed by a 400-pounder.
Look out, Lex Luger. This for an upset. What an upset 1 week from tonight. Two. Whoa.
My goodness. Lex that Luger, was so close.
Lex Luger very, very slow to get up. He may be hurt seriously.
Lex Luger headed to the Royal Rumble, as is Bastion Booger. And Booger is taking it to the American Original. Bastion Booger all over Lex Luger. And this is what Lex will have to contend with in the Royal Rumble. Size, bulk, weight. Although he'll have to not contend with one individual, but 29 others.
Look out, here he comes, the head of Steve Miller.
You're not going to slam a man like that.
I can't believe he didn't get him up. He got Yokozuna. Apparently, he wasn't quite psyched enough to pick up Bastion Booger.
And again, leverage and momentum and everything so much a part of what Lex Luger has done with Yokozuna. However, as you can see, the big man Booger has no problem in slamming Lex Luger. Oh, look out. Off the rope. 400 pounds down across the that could do it. One, two, yes, no. Oh,
barely.
A kick out by Lex Luger. And Bastion Booger is all over the American Original. He comes again for another squash. Luger moving out of the way just in the nick of time. Lex Luger needs to keep away from the big man. He needs to wear him down. Get that tank registering down around the E mark and then go for it. Lex Luger working on the sizable midsection. Now upstairs. Luger, what's he going to do now? Luger on the second rope. Lex Luger! Double hammer into the forehead. Luger now with Booger. To backfire again. Luger coming ever so close to being pinned by this huge Bastion Booger.
Quite possibly Lex Luger was
fighting. Hey, look at that. Luger knocks through the ropes to the outside.
Start to say this, quite possibly Lex Luger was fights on the Royal Rumble. He may have overlooked Bastion Booger, and that's a big mistake, as you can well tell now.
Lex Luger, several weeks ago, I believe, victorious over Jacques the Quebecer, but he's having no luck at all this week. Oh, this is going to do it. This is going to do it. Here comes Booger! Oh, no. The whole ring moved. Wait a minute. Booger's on his feet. Lex Luger is somehow on his feet. Booger with Booger shoves him into the ring. Booger with momentum. How can he have momentum after that? He does. Off the rope. Another clothesline. Booger's rock. Booger stays. And up. Hot goes Booger.
The crowd to their feet then.
And look out off the rope and off the rope again.
The forearm.
The flying forearm, the cover, the hook to leg, the count is straight. Once again, Lex Luger's overcome tremendous odds. Lex Luger will never give up. Oh, there's no doubt Lex Luger is a winner. But will Lex Luger be the man who wins the WWF Royal Rumble?
First thing I want to do is congratulate the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty on beating the Quebecers for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team belts.
Yeah, well, that's just great. You know, I just can't believe it, Brett. Every time we get our big break, my big break, something like this has got to happen.
Don't even worry about it, because I know that the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty are jam up, and they'll be the first ones to give us a title shot, especially after we beat the Quebecers in the Royal Rumble. You know, I want to make a big announcement. I'm really happy to say this. For the time being, actually, for the rest of my career, I am going to dedicate myself to strictly tag team wrestling. All my singular matches are going to be done. All my contract obligations will be completed. But after that, I'm sticking into tags with you, Owen, and it's going to be my promise. My promise to my family, to you, and myself that we will win the World Wrestling Federation tag team belts, and we're going to do it for each other.
Maybe we'll get a chance.
Last Monday night, Marty Jannetty, 1-2-3 kid, you pulled the upset of the century. I can't believe it. It was a fluke. We weren't ready. I don't know what happened, but I'll tell you what. I made sure there was a clause in the contract that we would get a return match just in case. This Monday night, Madison Square Garden, the return match.
That's right. This Monday night, 1-2-3 kid, Marty Jannetty, we vow we'll get our titles back. Because we're going next week to Royal Rumble to defend our titles for you, the Hearts. You be ready!
Ah! New tag team champions. What about that? You Quebecers aren't laughing so much now, are you? You know, last time you took us a little bit light, you said that we didn't have a chance in the world. You just didn't care, did you? Well, why does it feel like now? I tell you what, this coming Monday night, though, you get one more chance to prove that this was a fluke, like you're saying. If you don't get it done, tuck those tails and head back to Canada. Tell them, kid.
That's right, Quebecers. In a Madison Square Garden, we'll just see if it was a fluke. We're going to defend these belts against you guys, and hopefully we'll keep them.
No, not hopefully. We will.
Gentlemen, I want to thank you all for being with us here. And before we speak to you, I'd like for us all to see a piece of videotape that we've just received. It seems as if this giant double-wide casket.
Don't say that word, Jim Ross. Don't listen to him.
All right,
don't say that word. I've told you 20 million times. Don't say that
all
word.
Right, maintain your composure. Ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at this very special feature from The Undertaker and Paul Bear.
Oh, Yokozuna. It's finally ready. My Undertaker has just finished putting the final touches on your 1994 model casket. And oh, yes, it's such a beauty. Would you like to see it? Come a little closer. Yes, for the unveiling. Oh. Oh, yes. And just look at the sleek line, doll. Double wide, double deep, and most of all, no mileage at all. But Yokozuna, in order to ride in my Undertaker's masterpiece, you don't even have to kick the tires. All you have to do is kick the bucket! Oh, yes! Yes! Oh, let's take a look on the inside. Oh, but it will be a ride that you'll never forget. And when my Undertaker slams the door on your new 1994 vehicle and you ride into the darkness, why, you won't hear any exterior noise at all.
The only thing you will hear, Yokozuna, is the hounds of hell baying for your soul.
Well, obviously, gentlemen, all of you are visibly upset. And Mr. Cornette, for once, why don't you just tell the truth?
You hornswoggled me, Jim Ross. I didn't know you were going to show that thing.
Why don't you admit to the world that Yokozuna is indeed afraid of this casket? Tell the truth for once.
All right. He's afraid of the box. That's what he's afraid of. He's afraid of the box. He's not afraid of the Undertaker. He's just afraid of the box. And it's because of the World Wrestling Federation, because of all the fans, because of Jack Tunney, and because of The Undertaker and Paul Bearer that he's in this spot to begin with. It's some kind of put-up deal, some kind of con job. Well, let me tell you something, Undertaker, and you listen to me real good, punk, you and Paul Bearer. You backed him into a corner, so now he's only got one way to go. He's going to come out fighting. And I guarantee you this, at the Royal Rumble, you're going to have a long road to hoe, brother. You get in the ring with this man, this monster. He's going to do everything in his power. He's going to summon up everything he's got in his gut because he's going to be fighting out of instinct, not because he wants to. You've scared him with the only thing that he's ever been afraid of in his life. And now he's going to turn on you, Undertaker, and he's going to give you a taste of your own medicine. Yes. So Paul Bearer better be ready with all the fixings and all the trimmings for a first-class funeral, because at the Royal Rumble, that's exactly what it's going to be. Yeah. It's going to be a funeral. and a bit that's long been overdue for The Undertaker. Yes. He's going to be laid to rest. And the hopes and the dreams of Paul Bearer, The Undertaker, the World Wrestling Federation, and all the fans of getting the belt away from the big man are going to go down with him. You be ready, Undertaker, to Royal Rumble, because I guarantee you, we will be.
1 week away from the Royal Rumble. Crush, let me give you a warning. You're not going to rain on my parade. No, you're not. Because I'm going to win the Royal Rumble. And I'm going to go on to WrestleMania 10. And I'm going to win the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt for a third time. Yeah, the Macho Man is back. And back better than ever. Yeah. Royal Rumble, get ready. Because the madness is kicked in. And I'm going to win. Oh, yeah.
Royal Rumble just 1 week away. And you can be sure we're gearing up.
You know it, Bart, that's 30 guys in the ring all after each other for one thing at WrestleMania, because you face a champion, whoever that might be. And you know, it's every man for himself, partner.
That's right. It might go back to the old days. We used to duke it out in the barn.
It might, when old Mom and Pa used to have to pull us apart, and believe me, they were good ones.
You know, when you're the best, your work is never done. That and the kid and I are tag team champions. We're looking for something else, the Royal Rumble. And you know, when their kid have got this figured out, it's every man for himself. We'll stick together, get rid of everybody else. And when it comes down to you and me, we'll shake hands. And when you turn around, I'll throw you over the top rope.
No, I'm going to throw you over the top.
Oh, we'll see about that. I'm going to win the thing.
Gentlemen, standing by, our colleague Raymond Rougeau. He's in Lowell, Massachusetts to talk to the Macho Man Randy Savage. Let's listen in. Oh, yeah, dig it.
Tremendous ovation here for the Macho Man Randy Savage.
Mr. Intensity of the WWF. WWF champion has the fight of his career on his hands now with his former best friend Crush.
Certainly has his work cut out for him at the Royal Rumble. A lot of guys are going to be sharpshooting for the Macho Man.
We are solidly behind the Macho Man with a double thumbs up. Boy, they love him. He is a real legend. WWF superstars that are two-time World Wrestling Federation champions. Now, winning the Royal Rumble, meaning the winner gets a World Wrestling Federation championship match at WrestleMania 10, you could be a three-time World Wrestling Federation champion.
Oh, yeah.
With your recent encounters with Crush, I would assume that you'd be looking forward to seeing him, to meeting him in the Royal Rumble matchup.
Ooh, yeah. Sometimes when you journey through your life, you encounter friends that turn out not to be your friends, and they stab you in the back. But then, when you encounter those friends again, revenge can be so sweet. So Crush, it's not like I dread you, man. It's kind of like sweetness, yeah. Sweet revenge, oh yeah. 10 years ago, WrestleMania 1 in Madison Square Gardens launched the WWF into the stratosphere of sports entertainment. And now, that big rocket ship called the WWF is about to kick in its afterburners, yeah, and continue on into orbit, and continue on into outer space with WrestleMania 10. And the Macho Man Randy Savage plans to be in the nose of that rocket ship called the World Wrestling Federation and steer that rocket ship right in to the 21st century. Oh, yeah!
Macho Man Randy Savage, ready for the challenge of his career, as we said. He's ready for the WWF Royal Rumble. He could be the man that faces the WWF Champion Gorilla at WrestleMania 10.
Boy, wouldn't that be something, a three-time WWF Champion!
Well, I'll tell you something, that is by far the biggest casket I have ever seen.
Well, it looked to me, Jim Ross, like there was room in there for a lot of folks. Not only Yokozuna, but perhaps Mr. Fuji, James E. Cornette, and anybody else that decides to get in the way of the Grim Reaper.
I think you could raise a small family of three or four in that double wide. You know, I talked to Jim Cornette, Yokozuna, and Mr. Fuji earlier in the week. And the Cornette finally came clean. Indeed, Yokozuna is very apprehensive about this casket match.
In other words, he's scared.
He doesn't want any part of being locked into a giant box.
Stuffed in there. I don't blame him. Would you like that feeling, having the lid slam shut and some big 10-inch nails driven in to hold it? No. No, thank you.
I'll pass. Yeah, I will pass on that one.
Kind of a permanent solution to a temporary problem.
I think we can certainly expect to see the WWF champion at his most aggressive best. He had everything to on the line here.
Well, I don't know, Jim Ross, whether a lot of people realize it or not, but this is the only time in the history of the World Wrestling Federation that the title has been contested in this particular manner. Very unusual.
And I think back at all those casket matches that The Undertaker has won. He's beaten every WWF superstar that has ever faced him with this type of stipulation.
With no exceptions.
Absolutely no exception. Pinfalls do not count. Submissions do not count. You've got to incapacitate your opponent enough to be able to put him in that giant box.
That nice duck under there. Whoa!
Corey Student trying to get some offense here, but don't look for much out of this Student. He won't be staying after school. Boy, the intensity in the face of the WWF champion. Got to be around 600 pounds right now. So much on the mind of Mr. Fuji. Oh, look out.
Whoa! Well, a lot indeed on the minds of Fuji and James E. They're not only thinking about that humongous casket, they're thinking about Lex in the Royal Rumble itself, but here I think Fuji thought a moment chance for himself in Tenaru, and
the great Kabuki.
The great Kabuki, very Kabuki-ish.
Tenaru and Kabuki, both in the WWF Royal Rumble, no doubt, will be focusing on Lex Luger, but that man must think only about...
Wait a minute.
Yokozuna.
Where is he?
At the Royal Rumble this week. When I slam that casket lid shut.
Where is he? I don't see him anywhere.
Your lights will go out.
Oh, and the lights did go out.
Oh, man. The champion doesn't like this. Look at Yokozuna.
Pressure right about now.
This is the Leary. Yokozuna.
He's looking for the way out.
And the Undertaker just about 1 week away from the WWF Royal Rumble.
That's fear on that face.
doesn't want to even think about being locked into that giant casket. Wow. I believe we will see a new WWF champion crown in 1 week at the WWF Royal Rumble.
Ditto.
I'll see you in Royal Rumble. Okay.
Macho Man Randy Savage and Crash McGillivray right here on Monday Night Raw. Macho Man Randy Savage perched on the top rope. The official trying to get him down. They don't want to wait till this Saturday night. They want to go at it right now. However, we'll be back with Randy Savage against Irwin R. Scheister when we return with more Monday Night Raw.
We're back with more Monday Night Raw. Irwin R. Scheister coming out. Oh, look at this. They're going to go at it tooth and nail. Irwin R. Scheister and the Macho Man Randy Savage. Scheister has Macho Man back to the corner.
Feel him, Irwin. Get him, though.
Randy Savage to the buckle. Irwin R. Scheister, consummate professional, snapping Macho Man Randy Savage over. Irwin R. Scheister drops the elbow.
Nice elbow. Vince, did you see the fear in the Macho Man eyes?
No, I didn't see any fear, no.
When he was looking at me, brother, you didn't see the fear? Oh, be quiet. You don't know nothing, bro. He doesn't want me in the ring. He doesn't want to get crushed in the ring because I'm going to take him apart piece by piece. I can't wait to get my hands on him in the Royal Rumble. I hate the Macho Man.
Irwin R. Scheister headed to the Royal Rumble as well, ladies and gentlemen, not to enter the 30-man every man for himself matchup. Irwin R. Scheister will be squaring off against the one and the only bad guy, the Intercontinental Champion Razor Ramon. Irwin could become the champion at the Royal Rumble.
Could become and will become, Vince. Look at this. Last week, Macho Man threw the cake in Irwin's face, but look who's eating the cake now.
Oh, beautiful. Yes, indeed.
Yeah, give them to me.
The question is, will there be anything left in the Macho Man Randy Savage? If this match continues this way, will there be anything left of Macho Man at the Royal Rumble?
I hope so, but I don't think so. Irwin R. Scheister has given him the beating of his life, just like he deserves, bro.
Jones, oh my goodness, all the way down to the floor. Irwin back in the ring. Randy Savage has really had the stuffings knocked out of him, and look at the man with the tie.
Good job, Irwin. Way to go, brother.
Irwin R. Scheister could be the next Intercontinental Champion. He already, we believe, has some of Razor's gold that Razor used to wear around his neck.
Vince, what's the Macho Man doing in that chair? Oh, good for you.
The official taking control here, and Randy Savage hammered from behind. I believe Randy Savage was coming over here for you.
You know what, Vince? I can honestly tell you I hate this Macho Man. You know, you people out there, you think I got a big mouth. Well, I wish somebody would step up and shut my mouth, because nobody can. I'm the biggest and the toughest and the baddest in the World Wrestling Federation, and
Savage,
I'm going to take this punk apart.
Savage now hanging on to the ankle. Randy Savage puts the brakes on. Randy Savage spins Irwin around, and Scheister for the ride off the road. Yes, first for never.
Get up, Irwin.
Randy Savage on attack. Pouring it on. We'll be right back. Stay with us. We're back with more Monday Night Raw. Irwin R. Scheister, Macho Man Randy. Oh, no. Drop Randy Savage across the retaining barrier.
Hopefully he bit his tongue off again, but I don't have to listen to his big mouth anymore.
Irwin
good job,
back
Irwin.
In the ring. Randy Savage last week on our 1 year anniversary jammed the birthday cake into Irwin R. Scheister's face, and he deserved it. But right now, it looks like Irwin is getting the best of Randy Savage.
They honor him, Irwin. The Macho Man doesn't give up. I'll attest to that. The guy's got guts. He's got courage. But I still hate his guts.
Randy Savage being set up now by Irwin R. Scheister.
Suplex, brother.
And Irwin brings him in the ring the hard way.
Perfectly executed. Cover him and get this punk out of the ring.
Shyster taking his time for the cover. Finally hooks the leg. Two and he gets kicked out again.
Like I said, Vince, I will give the Macho Man this. He's got guts. He's got determination. He's got experience.
That's
or he
a chokehold. And that's a chokehold right
that
there. Come
not
on, Ralph.
Chokehold. Open. What do you know about chokeholds, Vince?
It looks like that forearm is underneath the chin. Look.
Oh, it's right on the button.
Herman R. Shyster against Macho Man Randy Savage. What a matchup here on Monday Night Raw.
IRS could easily turn this hold into a sleeper and put the Macho Man out.
What a matchup it's going to be at the Royal Rumble this Saturday. It's pay-per-view. The way pay-per-view should be only from the World Wrestling Federation. Randy Savage with an elbow. Trying to break the hold and does indeed now. Savage with another right hand.
Close fist again. Ooh. All right. Nice All move.
Irwin is so deft, so dexterous. This man has unbelievable agility and coordination. Irwin R. Shyster, the consummate wrestler. Randy Savage, more of a brawling type. Randy Savage wrestles more with his heart than he does his head. Two and a kick out again.
Look at Irwin taking him apart piece by piece. First the neck, then the leg. I tell you what, like you said, he is a master wrestler.
Kick out! No, not quite. Irwin, unbelievable offense on IRS.
Gotta stay on the Macho Man. Gotta stay on him.
Irwin R. Shyster, better known as IRS. Speaking of the government block, by the way, Bill Clinton has returned, as you know. President of the United States returning back here to America. Oh, my!
There you
Just
go,
in time for Monday Night Raw.
Always thinking, there you go. One, two, three.
One, two. Another kick out by Randy Savage.
Barely kicked out, Vince.
What a matchup.
It's been non-stop action since the ringing of the bell.
Irwin R. Shyster trying to wear down Randy Savage. I don't think that can be done. I don't know what it is you have to do to defeat Randy Savage.
I'll show you exactly what it takes.
Oh, look at that maneuver.
As soon as he gets in the ring with me. Yeah, grab him by the tights, quite a maneuver.
Oh yeah, well Randy Savage will do what he thinks he has to do to win. He'll fight fire with fire, which is why
Watch
Randy
out.
Savage, look at that. Oh my goodness.
Stabbed him right in the back, just like he did to me.
Randy Savage hammering IRS. Randy Savage with a right hand will return. Wait a minute, he's coming this way. He's coming. Wait a minute. Please, sit down. Please. Randy Savage, dead on the canvas. Sure.
Now you want to go after him, don't
you? He's trying to get himself disqualified, so Irwin will quit beating him up.
Randy Savage, ready to enter the ring. We'll return with more action. We apologize for taking the break. Stay with us. We're back with Monday Night Raw. And Irwin R. Shyster with the abdominal stretch on Macho Man. Randy Savage, what a matchup this has been. This matchup has taken a great deal out of both competitors. I believe more out of Randy Savage, though, than Irwin.
This has been like a street fight, Vince. I tell you what, but look where Irwin's got right now.
Yeah, look at him hanging on the top rope.
Hey, fight fire with fire. That's what I say, brother. The Macho Man's been cheating since the start of this match. I say give him whatever you want to, Irwin.
What's this now? Irwin to the outside. Look at this. Randy Savage, quick as a cat. Savage snapping Irwin in. Randy Savage himself to the outside. Savage going out. Randy Savage with unbelievable tenacity. And yes, no.
Yes.
No. Irwin sidestep. The onslaught of Randy Savage.
That's called presence of mind, Vince. Irwin, I tell you what, he is a heck of a wrestler.
Cover. Leg hook and an easy kick out by Randy Savage.
Right back to that chin lock, brother.
Irwin R. Shyster with Randy Savage. Both men headed to the Royal Rumble this Saturday. Yes, hooked up the bottom rope there. Come on, ref, break it up, break it up. Come on.
Went to the rope because he knew it's just a matter of time before he's asleep. That was a sleeper hold.
And a slam by Irwin.
All right. Stick a fork in the Macho Man. He's done.
Irwin to the outside again. A high risk maneuver coming up. Yes. Irwin on Shyster going up. Randy Savage is spit. No, he's Ooh. Not. Beautiful maneuver. Savage playing possum as only Randy Savage can. This matchup continuing. Savage for the cover. One, two, three, no.
Oh, my. What a cheap shot that was, Vince. I can't believe it. Look at this. Across the top rope. Now, what do you call that, McMahon?
Just what you called it earlier on. Fighting fire with fire.
Yeah.
And this matchup may continue until we're off the air.
It's okay. I can't take this anymore, Vince. I can go after this punk. He's making me sick.
Crush, get out. Crush is right up. He just shoved right in Savage. I can't believe it. Crush can take no more. Look at this. Lashley. Oh, wait, that's going to cost him. That's going to cost him big. That's going to cost him big. Irwin and Crush double teaming Randy Savage. Another official coming down.
Crush and Irwin on Shyster. Have thrown caution to the lid.
Wait a minute. The Punk coming in to try and help out.
Crush and Savage. Gut red suplex down on the knee.
Officials trying to maintain control and look at Crush intimidating all of them.
Crush and Irwin continuing to onslaught on Randy.
Wait a minute. What's this? Crush going. Yokozuna coming out of ringside. What's he doing here? He has no business here. They're all going to gang up on Randy Savage. That's what it is. Tatanka back in to try and help out. Tatanka chomping away at Irwin. Yokozuna, the World Wrestling Federation champion, choking Randy Savage. Come on!
Pandemonium has broken loose!
Pandemonium has broken loose here on Monday Night Raw! Yokozuna,
wait a minute.
Lex Luger, what's he doing here? Luger out of fire! Luger hammering away! Luger and Yokozuna going out! Here comes Shawn Michaels. Here comes Diesel. Why? We've got our own mini WWF Royal Rumble going on right now. Here comes the Hitman Red Arm. The dressing room is emptying. The action all over the place. The Royal It's supposed to begin this Saturday night, but I think we're seeing a prelude as to what will happen right now.
Just like we promised, we said we were going to win the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team titles back, and we did it. Marty Jannetty, 1-2-3 Kid, thanks for shining the belts for us. Now tonight, Royal Rumble, Hart Brothers, we didn't lose the belts and regain them just to lose them to you two geeks. We're going to keep the belts tonight at Royal Rumble, and we hope you two beat the snot out of each other.
Let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, when we're going to defend our title against the Harts, we're going to show you what really brotherly love is all about.
Oh, Yokozuna, it's time for your journey. It's time for your journey into the dark side. You may be afraid. Oh, yes, you may be deathly afraid. Tonight, Yokozuna, my Undertaker will fill the specially built casket with your behemoth carcass and the deterioration process. Oh, it will soon begin. Are you afraid, Yokozuna? Are you afraid? Oh!
Fear not, Yokozuna. You shouldn't be afraid. You should be terrified. Rest in peace.
As good as they are individually,
we have to be better collectively. And speaking of the collective, tag team combination.
The smoking guns.
And they have been smoking.
The smoking guns.
actual Royal Rumble matchup.
Yes, the Smoking Guns, just one more brother team in the Royal Rumble. It's going to be interesting. Billy and Mark giving everything they have every time they come to the squared circle. And every week you can see that they have yet another look out from behind. Adam Bomb smashing away on Billy. Adam Bomb jumps Billy head first to the buckle. Adam Bomb now kicking to the midsection. Adam Bomb hammering away on Billy Gunn.
Though Billy should have known better, you never turn your back on someone who has radiation sickness.
Oh my, look at that. And Adam Bomb having his problems now with Billy. Nice arm drag takedown. Billy and Bob Gunn are really climbing the ladder of success. For that matter, so is Adam Bomb. The wily veteran on the outside, the model Rick Martel. And this is the very first time we have seen Martel and Adam Bomb in action as a tag team. As we mentioned before, hip toss nicely up by Billy. Arm drag takedown nicely done to the arm bar. Billy and Bart, as we said before, have been smoking. They're a great tag team with a great future. We spoke to them earlier on about the Royal Rumble.
The Royal Rumble, and it's tonight, and we're getting awfully excited.
You know, it's every man for himself. And the winner gets a shot at the champion at WrestleMania. And I'm not going to let that opportunity get away from me.
Neither will I.
We'll see.
Ooh, that's interesting.
Yeah, a little friendly competition there. Maybe not so friendly. Uh-oh. Putting on the brakes, Martel. Dropkick lunging in to Bart. Bart now with a big slam on the model. And this is not modeling, Mr. Martel. No. This is the WWF.
That Yokozuna's
the Undertaker.
Oh, no, look at that.
And that casket.
Did you see what Adam Bomb did? He pulled the top rope down.
The referee didn't even see it.
Had he seen that, he would have to have disqualified Adam Bomb. Oh, oh no, he didn't even see that either. What will the officials see at the Royal Rumble? We know what we're going to see. We're going to see someone crown the winner of the Royal Rumble. And who knows, we may see a new WWF champion. And speaking of the Royal Rumble, we're very proud to say that Radio WWF will bring you the Royal Rumble as well, all across the entire world, courtesy of the Armed Forces Network. Some 160 countries will hear the WWF Royal Rumble event. Here comes Adam Bomb. Your impressions thus far, Stan, as far as Bomb and Martel are concerned, tag team unit.
Well, when you combine the match savvy of Rick the Model Martel and the awesome physical power of Adam Bomb, you have a very impressive tag team.
Come on, ref. The legal man is Martel.
They did tag him.
Double clothesline.
Well, they have a four count, but the ref didn't count it.
The model with Martel now with Bart. And Bart trying to make his way over to tag his brother Billy. Getting closer and closer.
Look like
Martel. He can't do restrain Bart from making the tag. Adam Bomb comes in and come on, ref, get in there. Oh, look at that. Bart taking matters into his own hands. Reversal, however, to the buckle.
Oh, my goodness.
Martel ran right into that huge boot and Billy wanting Bart to make the cover or the tag. Getting closer and closer.
Billy's fired up. He's fresh now.
Billy Gunn hammering away. Series of right hands. Now Martel for the ride. To the buckle. And out. Up and down to the canvas. Adam Bomb on the receiving end as well. Adam Bomb set up. Perhaps double team, double drop kick.
All four mids still in the ring.
Look at that. Talk about focusing as a unit.
Qualification, the Smoking Guns.
You wonder whether or not Martel would have been able to kick out of that cover. And I guess we're never going to know. It's a disqualification. The Smoking Guns victorious.
Well, that's got to be embarrassing. The first time they ever tag up, and look what happens.
Martel's angry. Wait a minute. Let's stay with this. We'll be right quick for Shelly Martel. Stay with that. Harvey Rumble's going to get nailed. Adam Bomb coming in from behind. Oh, look at this. We've seen this before. They don't like each other. We may never see them tag team up again. They're not going to wait for the Royal Rumble. Adam Bomb said, let's go.
Get it on now. They can sure get it on the Royal Rumble.
It's every man for himself. And you're going to see these two go at it if they have the chance during the Royal Rumble matchup. I don't believe Martel will ever team up with Adam Bomb again. Standing by, Jim Ross, let's take you to phase two.
Ladies and gentlemen, when my next guest step out of the ring at tonight's WWF Royal Rumble, perhaps they will be the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. Let's welcome Brett and Owen, the Hart Brothers.
Yes, what a tremendous opportunity for the Hart Brothers. However, let's listen in to Ray Rougeau in the interview. Let's see if he's going to ask them about the Royal Rumble matchup. Let's see if he's going to ask them about the fact that they will be competing with each other, notwithstanding their collective effort.
Owen, a lot of things have happened, a lot of things have been said that frankly have been quite divisive. Now, they have hurt the fans, they have obviously hurt your family, well, I'm sure they have hurt both of you, but how are things right now? I mean, tonight's a big match.
Ray, honestly, I want you to listen and listen good. Everything is okay between me and Brett. I honestly, everything is great. Things haven't been better between Brett and I. Tonight is going to be our night. And I just want you to picture this. Five different times, I watched my brother Brett come home, and he brought a different WWF belt home, and he laid it on that dining room table. And Mom and Dad, they watched, and it was a sight to see. God, it made us all so proud. Well, tonight, Mom, tonight, Dad, this is going to be my night with Brett, because we're going for those WWF belts, and this is going to prove to everybody that it really can happen. I'm finally going to get my big break. I'm finally going to get my chance, and it's going to be great. The Rocket is going to be blasting off higher than he's ever gone before, and the Hitman, he's going to be right on top of that Rocket. And you know where we're going? Straight to the top. The Quebecers, you guys are going down. The Rocket and the Hitman, we're going to be number one.
All right. You know, Brett, at the risk of sounding redundant, I mean, the things have obviously been said. There has to be scar tissue. How do you feel about this?
Well, if you're asking me whether it hurt the little altercation that I had with my brother, it's like he said, it's water under the bridge. It is over and done with, and it doesn't matter anymore because we are a unit. We are two brothers going to the very top. And tonight in the Royal Rumble, you're going to find out that the Hart Brothers are the greatest team combined together in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. And as far as the Quebecers go, tonight, when you lose against the Hart Brothers, I want you to know one thing, that we're winning these championship belts, the World Wrestling Federation championship belts. We are going to win them for ourselves. We are going to win them for our family. But most of all, we are going to win for you fans out there. This is it. It's showtime in the Royal Rumble. And the Hart Brothers, there is no stopping us now.
The Rumble is coming, it's coming. The Rumble is coming.
The Rumble! Here we go, once again, the Royal Rumble is on. But who is gonna win? The Rumble's on the rock, the Thomas on the top. We'll battle it out till each man has had enough. We're gonna do them, who's gonna drop? To be eliminated, you have to go over the top. So get ready, the Rumble is coming. One was the vibe and the rest will rumble. So it's coming straight to you. The list goes on and it reads like a who's who. We'll be right back. We got Olympic, Lex Bret Hart, and Double J, Scott and Rick Steiner, and Diesel's going to play. But your man, Tatanka, Joyce LeClair, men on the missions in the house, they're all going down. We got the head shrinkers, the Rocket Owen Hart, Adam Ball, Funky Jerms, yeah, they got Hart, Bob Backlund and Booker, when it stands up, the Great Kabuki and Kamala, and Greg Valentine, Shawn Michaels, Crush, Model Rick Martel, at the sound of the bell, every man for himself, all phones, no friends, the winner meets the champ of WrestleMania, then
it's coming, the rumble is coming, it's coming, the rumble is coming, it's coming, the rumble is coming, it's coming. The rumble is coming!
So it's coming straight to you. And you can see it only your pain from you. We're coming on strong, solid, symbolic. We're gonna rock Providence, Rhode Island. We're not gonna tumble, won't be humble. We're gonna rock at the Royal Rumble.
It's coming. The rumble is coming, it's coming. The rumble is coming, it's coming. The rumble is coming, it's coming. The rumble is coming!
At this time will be at the WWF Royal Rumble tonight to defend his coveted World Wrestling Federation Championship, accompanied by his manager, Mr. Fuji, and his American spokesperson, Jim Cornette. He is Yokozuna!
Well, Gorilla, Yokozuna certainly looks ready for any and all challenges, and of course, he's going to be a part of the big Monday Night Raw taping 1 week from tomorrow night in the Fernwood Resort in Bushkill, Pennsylvania. The WWF returning to the Fernwood Resort in Bushkill, Pennsylvania. Yokozuna, the 600-pound WWF champion, will be there. Lex Luger on the card. Macho Man Randy Savage. Bret the Hitman Hart. What an event. Fernwood Resort, Bushkill, Pennsylvania, 1 week from tomorrow night.
Fuji made the mistake.
They're the ones that said it.
They should have read the contract closer.
Do you see what you've done? No, don't worry, Yoko. Don't worry. All right. I'm going to admit it. It's obvious everybody can see it. It's plain as the nose on anybody's face. The World Wrestling Federation has accomplished what they set out to do. All the fans have accomplished what they set out to do. And most of all, the Undertaker has accomplished what he set out to do. Yokozuna is scared. He's afraid. Watch it. I've never seen him like this. Mr. Fuji's never seen him like this. I didn't think that Yokozuna was afraid of anything on the face of the planet. But he's scared of this. He's not scared of the Undertaker. No, he's not. He's scared of that box. But let me just say this. I've said many times. Well, let me just ask you a question, Undertaker, Paul Bearer. What happens when you frighten an animal in the wild, huh? What happens when you frighten a savage beast? He's got two choices, two options to take. One, he can turn and he can run as far as he can go, as fast as he can go, as long as he can go until he drops. Or he can turn and fight. And he'll fight as long and as hard as he has to. Now, does this look like Bambi to you? Does this look like a frightened deer that would turn and hop through the woods and run off? No, I don't think so.
I don't think so, Undertaker. I don't think so, Paul Bearer. I think that he'll fight. I think he'll fight hard. I think he'll fight you with everything he's got in his body, as long and as hard and as mean as he has to. He'll fight you tooth and nail. He'll fight you to the end. He'll fight you till he drops or until you do. That's the way it's going to be at the Royal Rumble. He's going to fight with fear in his heart and panic in his eyes because he's fighting for his survival, Undertaker. So you've done what you set out to do. You've frightened an animal. But now you have to confront that animal with his fangs bared like a grizzly bear. There's going to be a funeral at the Royal Rumble. We know that for sure, brother. But whose funeral is it going to be? Is it going to be the Undertaker's? An event that's long overdue? Or is it going to be Yokozuna's? Well, I know what public opinion would like to see happen. But I also know what me and Mr. Fuji are betting on. We're betting on an Undertaker that when those fangs get bared, when the two forces collide at the Royal Rumble, in that match, with that title hanging in the balance, that long overdue event, the Undertaker's funeral, will take place. Because when you give this man a choice, when it's either him or it's you, then, brother, your future is looking very, very dim because you ain't going to make it tonight at the Royal Rumble, Undertaker. The bell will toll for the final time. What's on?
Wow. What a matchup.
It'll be a classic.
No doubt about it. I can't wait.
As co-winners of the WWF Royal Rumble match, both Lex Luger and Bret Hart unquestionably deserve the opportunity to challenge the WWF champion at WrestleMania 10. Therefore, it is my decision that both superstars will indeed have their just opportunity. For the first time in WrestleMania history, the WWF title will be defended not once, but twice at the same event. And there could be no greater event than WrestleMania 10 at Madison Square Garden. Let me elaborate. This Monday night, there will be a coin toss to determine who will be the competitor to face Yokozuna, assuming, of course, that Yokozuna is the champion at WrestleMania 10. If Lex Luger wins the coin toss, he will face Yokozuna, which means that Bret Hart would then face suitable competition. In this case, his brother, Owen Hart. After the Bret Hart-Owen Hart match, Bret then would face the winner of the Lex Luger-Yokozuna match. However, if Bret Hart wins the coin toss this Monday night, then he will face Yokozuna, which means that Lex Luger would then also face suitable competition. In this case, Crush. After the Lex Luger-Crush match, Lex Luger would then face the winner of the Bret Hart-Yokozuna match. All three parties, Yokozuna, the current champion, Bret Hart, and Lex Luger, the current contenders, have agreed to this historic format, which will take place at WrestleMania 10. I believe, under the circumstances, this is a fair and equitable decision. Just one more thing. Unannounced guest referees acceptable to all parties will be assigned to the two championship matches at WrestleMania. Thank you.
This is the greatest day of my life, the greatest day of Mr. Fuji's life, and most of all, the greatest day of the life of the great Yokozuna, the World Wrestling Federation champion. Guys, the limousine's out back right now, the champagne corks are already popping, and it's going to be the biggest celebration that this city has ever seen, and it's going to be the biggest celebration in the history of the nation of Japan, because right now in Tokyo and all across the country, they're preparing to do the celebration. The fact that Yokozuna, the man that represents them, is still the World Wrestling Federation champion, and I told everybody, Mr. Fuji told everybody, despite all the weeks of the media barrage trying to sway public opinion, despite the conspiracy entered into by World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney and the whole organization, despite the inveterate attempts by Mr. Paul Bearer to do everything he could do to stack the deck against Yokozuna, The fact remains that mine and Mr. Fuji's prophecy came true, and he did what he said he was gonna do. Yokozuna remains the World Wrestling Federation champion, and he beat The Undertaker in his own match. Now, whatever happened around that, I don't know. Maybe Undertaker had some friends he was trying to get in the ring. I don't know what happened. All I know is, all by himself, Yokozuna kicked the prostrate form of The Undertaker into that casket and closed the lid. Not only on the match, like we always said, but on The Undertaker's career. Now, the green smoke, the specter, the apparition flying toward the heavens. I don't know what that's all about, but I don't have to, because after all, he's out of our hair. And now, the winners of the Royal Rumble for the first time ever. Controversy, turmoil, co-winners. This means that by the time my attorney's finished tying this thing up in court, brother, neither Lex Luger nor Bret Hart may ever get a shot, because they'll be old and gray. This is the greatest day in Yokozuna's
Bonsai!
This Monday night, ladies and gentlemen, live, we'll see the 1-2-3 kid against Johnny Polo. What a matchup. We'll see the coin toss, see just who wins the opportunity to face Yokozuna at WrestleMania, and then who will face the so-called suitable competition. Oh, baby, here we go. Gentlemen, start your engine.
That sounds like 383 cubic inches of small block V8, baby.
Screaming machine, ported and polished and ready to go.
The Brooklyn Brawler, ready to lock up with Sparky. Sparky Plug.
Oh, look at them poor old Brooklyn. We have got to pick up a collection by him new outfit. Look at that. That's us, our fine. And you know, as a matter of fact, if you'll give me that quarterback I was flipping a little while ago, I'll go ahead and put that in the pot.
Well, I don't know. 25 cents might be enough for a washing machine. I don't know. It'd take a little bit more than 25 cents, I would suggest, to change the sartorial splendor there of our friend Brooklyn Brawler. It looks like he's been sleeping underneath the Brooklyn Bridge.
Either that or those dual exhausts and those headers that blew some exhaust fumes out on him and dinged him up a little bit.
Yes, indeed. Thurman flies back to the corner. Roundhouse right misses. Thurman back out. Nice hip toss. Thurman Plug, friends call him Sparky.
And what a successful stock car driver. This man is, he's gone 185 miles an hour on the big tri-oval. Just imagine that.
It must be a thrill, yes indeed. Although that was not a thrill to collect that uppercut. Brooklyn Brawler coming back in another one. Brawler now is going to spoil the debut of Thurman Plug. Plug looks like he might be out of it on his feet. No, he goes downstairs. Right back up. Sparky Plug, a nice leapfrog. Plug now catches Brawler hip toss.
Oh,
and a scoop and a slam. Thurman Plug with a nice drop kick. And Thurman Plug reaching that red line zone. And Brooklyn Brawler to the outside.
Brooklyn Brawler heading to the pits, Vince.
Yes, exactly. Sparky Plug is headed to the Fernwood Resort of Bushkill, Pennsylvania this Monday night.
It's Monday Night Raw. Sparky along with Lex Luger, the Macho Man, to talk a razor about a host of WWF superstars. We'll be on hand for this Monday night. Monday Night Raw, scheduled to appear in Bushkill this Monday. Roundhouse right and another one. So fighting fire with fire now is Thurman Plug. Plug with missing with the roundhouse right, so does Brawler. Oh my goodness, did you see that? A slingshot there.
Right in the throat.
And Brawler being set up and snap suplex, nicely executed.
That was a speedway suplex, remember?
A speedway suplex. How about that? Thurman Plug certainly knows what he's doing.
Sparky Plug, he is hitting on all eight cylinders, brother. He's blueprinted, ready for action. Tremendous speedway suplex right there.
Yes, indeed, he made a successful.
Hey, look.
Oh, look at that. Here we go.
The overhead cam, and the Brooklyn Brawler gets a valve job, if you will.
That's taking out to a lunge.
the spirit of the Undertaker lives within the soul of all mankind. The eternal flame of life that cannot be extinguished. The origin of which cannot be explained. The answer lies in the everlasting spirit. Soon all mankind will witness the rebirth of the Undertaker. I will not rest in peace.
Quebecers, every time we wrestle you, you come up with a new stipulation. First it was a Quebec province rules, now you want a nine-title, 10-minute match. The way I see it, it's simple. We beat you in 10 next week. The following week, we go for the titles. Boys, it's just a dog eating me. We'll make you famous.
Yes. Can you feel it? Can you feel it? The spirit of my Undertaker. I feel it all around. In fact, I feel it the strongest right here. And the spirit of my Undertaker is alive in each and every one of you. Some say that my Undertaker is gone. But that couldn't be further from the truth. You must remember what my Undertaker said. He said he would never, never rest in peace. But you can mark my words. My Undertaker will return. He will return. Oh, yes, my Undertaker will return. Oh, yeah. He will return. He will return.
The spirit of the Undertaker felt by this capacity crowd in Birchkill, Pennsylvania. We are live here for Monday Night Raw. And you're about to hear a big ovation. No, not for Corey Student, but yes, indeed. Yes, indeed, things are starting to shake here. And take a look at this, coming back to the WWF.
I thought for a second there when you said there was going to be a big ovation, you were taking a walk, McMahon.
Oh, you're a riot. The earthquake, ladies and gentlemen, ready to lock up with Corey Student. Look out. Oh, my, look at this. Can he ever move? Look out from behind, Corey Student attacking the earthquake. Student trying to lock up. Coming off the ropes now. Uh-oh, look at this. And belly to belly.
Oh, I know that didn't feel good, McMahon.
No, indeed not.
That's a lot of weight.
Student appears to be just that. The student and the teacher right now is he, what's this? Wait a minute, it has been confirmed. Marty Jannetty has accepted the challenge. Marty Jannetty to meet you, Irwin, right here next week on Monday Night Raw. What about it?
Do you have that in writing, McMahon? I'd like to see that document right now.
I don't
now.
Think you need it in writing. His word is his bond.
Oh, yeah, I trust Jannetty. Obviously, I trust him. I want it in writing before Monday Night Raw is finished tonight.
Oh, I don't think you're going to have a problem with that at all. Marty Jannetty, ladies and gentlemen, will in fact face Irwin Arn Scheister. What a matchup that's going to be right here on Monday Night Raw next week. And maybe the tax man will be paying for a change as opposed to collecting.
No, I don't think so, McMahon. As a matter of fact, I'm liable to get all the contents back in my briefcase before this one's over that they stole.
Oh, yeah, right. You mean the gold around the neck now of Razor Ramon. Razor with the gold around his waist and the gold around his neck as well. And look at this. Earthquake with Corey Student up there across the back. And drops him, has some pity on him. Quake.
This is Earthquake's debut, and he's already using illegal holds.
I see. By the way, Wednesday, a policeman's widow discovers the new man in her life could be her husband's killer. Oh my! Tim Daly and Lauren Holly star in Dangerous Heart, a USA World premiere movie, Wednesday night at 9, 8 Central, here on USA.
I think I might even watch that one, McMahon.
Sounds like your kind of movie.
What does that mean?
Well, I mean...
Never mind, never mind. I don't want to know.
I see.
I can imagine.
And back to the corner here. Oh, my goodness. Earthquake withstood it. And, oh, my! But you could, is being squashed.
You could say this guy is a slow learner, I would say.
Perhaps so. And the Earthquake measuring Mr. Student. Oh, forget about it. Oh, my. Earthquake is taking it.
There's a lot of people in big trouble because the Quake's back.
Yeah, you've got that right.
He wasn't talking to me, was he, McMahon?
I think he was looking right at you.
No, I don't think so.
Why don't you go ask Mr. Earthquake if he has paid his taxes? And, oh, what a power slam.
Maybe I will.
And it looks like Corey Student is ready to bite the dust. We feel the tremors coming, ladies and gentlemen. Look out. Earthquake
now. You should move right now.
Burn from it. Forget about it. An easy victory.
Hey, big man, that was a quick count, don't you think?
No. He could have counted to 100. Earthquake, victorious, and by the way, we are told that joining us momentarily will be Razor Ramon and Marty Jannetty with commentary. So we will be right back, ladies and gentlemen, with Razor and Marty. Stay with us. All right, back out here, ladies and gentlemen, with Erwin R. Scheister, and standing by, I believe, do we have Razor Ramon? There we go, Marty Jannetty, Razor Ramon. Look at the gold. It never looked better than it does right now around your race. Razor Ramon.
But how real about funny, the, McMahon. But here's a couple of thieves if I've ever seen one.
Hey, wait a minute. What about the matchup next week? Marty, you one-on-one with Razor Ramon.
You know, I want to say something, McMahon.
I beg your pardon.
And Taxman. Oye, me chico. You talking about you want Marty Jannetty? You got him.
Here I am. You know, isn't it typical of the IRS to kick a man while he's down? Take advantage of an unfair situation. The 1-2-3 kid sitting there with his leg in a cast, and you want to jump on him? Well, let me tell you something, IRS. For every man that's been abused by the IRS, you're going to get satisfaction in the form of Marty Jannetty kicking your butt. I'll tell you right now, you won't whoop me without the help of your stinking government. And you can take that to the bank and then steal it from yourself.
Thank you, Marty.